What's going on, people? Welcome to the LV Live Show. I am LV Live. Please hit that like, share, subscribe button. Once again, I want to thank all the new subscribers for coming by to my channel, man. It is truly, truly appreciated. Right, so let's get right into it. The Knicks win their seventh in a row by beating that team across the river, the Brooklyn Nets, 142-118. Talk about a blowout win. Oh, man. This is just beautiful, man. It can't get no better than that. The Knicks was scored pretty much 47 points in the first quarter, 81 points in the first half, led by Jalen Brunson, who had 30. Yeah, I said it, 30 points in the first half and finished off the game with 39. Last time he played the Nets, he had 40. They had nobody that could check him. The Knicks were just pretty much doing whatever they wanted for the whole game. It was just beautiful to see, man. It was just, like I said, a total team effort. Just beginning to end, they just jumped all over him, man, from the beginning. The Knicks were firing from downtown. Grimes was big tonight. He had 22 points. He was 8-for-9 from the three-point line. He was fabulous, man. You had great contributions from RJ. RJ had 15. Big Mitch had a double-double tonight. He had 13-10. Randle was huge tonight. He had 21-8. IQ was big off the bench. He had 15. Ihart had 8. Josh Hart only had 4. But listen, man, you know, his contributions aren't always points, right? It's just the active points, right? It's just getting busy and pretty much just getting deflections, getting rebounds, all those type of things that he does that's so good. I'm getting steals. It was just everybody was in on it, man. I mean, there's no better way. There's no better feeling you can have right now, man. Watching the Knicks play and just seeing everything that they're doing, just all together, right? You just have to be happy with what's going on, man. Let's get straight to the highlights here, right? Just all in all, man. Just all in all. I mean, you see me stuttering. I'm trying to figure out the right words. But all in all, you have to be happy, man. And with this win now, the Knicks are 1.5 game out of the fourth seed, guys. With Cleveland Cavaliers losing tonight to Boston, 1.5 games out. So they just got to keep this rolling. Just seeing just how they're playing hard as a team. But everybody knows where they're going. Everybody knows their responsibility, like I said before. One thing that Tibbs did state, one of his interviews, Tibbs stated, he said, listen, man, these guys are gym rats, man. I don't have to tell these guys to do certain things. They want it. They want to win. They want to be in a situation. So because of that, I don't have to tell them to do things. They just come and just automatically are in the gym working. They automatically work on certain things. They're shoot arounds early, right? Because guys want to get better. They want to win. And most importantly, man, once you start building a winning culture, guys don't care what their stat line is. Guys don't care. They just want to get the W, and they just want to get the win. And just seeing an effort like you saw tonight, especially after, last game playing Boston, was more of a defensive game. But tonight was just all offensive. The Knicks just showed. And pretty much what I love is they took care of business of a team that they're a lot better than. They took care of them, period. Like I said, 47 points in the first quarter. They let it be known, listen, we're going to take care of these guys early, and let's get them out of here and send them back across the river, right? That's exactly what I got from this game. And Jalen Brunson, man, listen, they have nobody for him. So he did exactly what he was supposed to do. Randle pretty much had great numbers, right? He had 23 points, I'm sorry. Then he had 8 rebounds, 8 assists, right? The double was coming. They were swinging the ball to the open shooters, and what guys doing like IQ and Grimes, knocking them down. The Knicks were huge tonight as far as that. Behind the arc, 23 pointers made. Offensive explosion tonight. Explosion, man. Because, just seeing the confidence that this team has, guys believing in each other. I really think everybody on this team likes each other. They really, really, truly do. And when you are playing like that and everyone likes each other, when they love each other and they're doing what I like to call, what I used to say when I played sports, it's like a brotherhood, right? That's what these guys are playing for because they're playing for each other. They're not playing for their stat line. They're not playing for a contract. They're playing for each other. And they know the name on the front of the jersey as opposed to the name behind the jersey, right? The name on the back of the jersey, excuse me. That right there is what we're building, right? We're building a beautiful culture, and it's great to see, because these are the games. This is how the Knicks should handle a team like this, like I stated, right? You get them out the gym early, right, to where you can prepare and get ready because you got – a lot of tough teams coming ahead. Like I said, they got the Heat on Friday, and then they got the Celtics Sunday, right, on ESPN. And I believe that's when they start the West Coast trip that following week. So they have a lot of tough games coming up, man. But this is the way you handle business tonight, right? So we just got to keep it rolling. It's a Friday when we play the Heat. All right? But listen, that's my show. I'm LV Lott. Please hit that like, share, subscribe button. Hit that like button. Hit that like button, people. All right? Also, too, if you come by, please leave comments. If it's your first time coming by, please leave comments. But also, please subscribe. All right? I'm LV Lott, and that's my show, and I'm out. Peace.